Now, the dancing continues as our couples hope to avoid the first dance-off of the series. And our next celeb's confidence should be sky-high because last week, Lorraine called her a warrior and Arthur gave her a perfect 10. But can she keep it going with her foxtrot? It's Ellen Keane and Stephen Vincent.
Oh, Ellen, this was a big number to take on. You ate it up. You've laid down the gauntlet tonight with this performance. It was wonderful.
Big, juicy 10!
We just got it.
I'm so happy for Ellen. I think she really, really deserved it. 6, 7. This week we're dancing the foxtrot. It's a very, very different dance to what we performed last week with the Paso Doble.
This is weird. My legs seem to know what's coming before I even know what the steps are.
So weird.
She's starting to act like a dancer. I'm really glad she's allowing that process to happen.
During this week, I've relaxed into it so much easier than before, and I'm hoping on Sunday that I'll be able to kind of glide across the dance floor and flow across the dance floor while showing how skillful I hopefully can be.
Dancing the Foxtrot, Ellen Keane and Stephen Vincent.
I mean, it beats wearing a pair of togs, doesn't it? Look at you.
Yes, it's fun. I might go to wardrobe and bring a few swimming togs with me.
Get them on, put sequins on them. Now, Arthur gave you a 10 last week. Let's see what he thought of that performance. Arthur, we'll go to you first.
Ellen, you are like a goddess, surprising us every time you step on the dance floor. The way you were moving your feet, it's like you were dancing on air. Like a light feather, like your stunning, beautiful dress tonight. It's very continuous flowing movements, you know? And you delivered that. J'adore.
J'adore. Brian.
Well, what I was most impressed about was the flexibility of the body, because when you're in frame, it can get a bit stiff. It takes real skill and confidence, which you talked about earlier on, to develop shape and fill space with that flexibility. My only issue was there was one or two moments you just got slightly out of sync with one another, and that just broke the flow of the dance. Flow is so important for foxtrot. So when the flow was there, it was excellent. It was just a shame with those odd moments where you got slightly out of sync. But overall, a good attempt at a very difficult dance.
Oh, okay. Good comments. Lorraine.
graceful, elegant, beautiful, the whole setting and how you look. And that is just so perfect for Foxtrot. And for me here, it was the smoothness that you had, the feather step, and a beautiful, not one heel turn, but two and three heel turns in there. And I can tell you, this is extremely difficult dance to do. And the other thing I have to admire you for is getting the balance between you. It's so, so good and so difficult. It was the speed, just a little bit slower, and Brian wouldn't have seen that, and we wouldn't have seen that little bit of bumping and that, just a little bit slower, but a great execution. Okay. Well done.
A difficult dance done beautifully. Give it up for Ellen and Stephen, everyone. Well done, guys.
Good job. Good job, Ellen. Now, last week you got your first 10 of the series. How were you feeling about tonight's performance going into it?
I was so excited. I think last week's performance, it was fierce, it was powerful, it was a Beyoncé song, and you really had to get into that character to really do the dance properly. And just the scores and the feedback really gave me the confidence going into this week. I kind of understood playing a character a bit more and performing, so that's what we tried to do today.
Okay, Stephen, I want to come to you because I want to pick up on what the guys have said. Brian said, impressed, obviously, with the flexibility of the body, but a good attempt, a very difficult dance, but out of hold, that balance kind of, did you understand what he was trying to say?
Yeah, I mean, Foxtrot is a very controlled dance. It has to be perfectly in sync with your partner. And, you know, maybe there were a few times where we just got a little bit out of sync with each other, but, you know, we're talking small stuff here. So
really?
I think she did a great job.
Leave her alone, Brian. Yeah. Small stuff. Listen, you guys are great. Let's see how you did. Scores are in.
The judges have their scores. Brian Redman.
7.
Lorraine Barrow.
8.
Yes.
Arthur Gulen-Leanne.
8.
There you go. That is a total of 23.